we're making vision prostheses that connect directly to the brain. In order to do that, we've had to design some miniature wireless devices that are tiny little modules that are about the size of a pencil eraser, that have electrodes that are so small that the tips of them, you could put 10 of them on one of your hair that's on your head. So they're that tiny. And they're injected into the brain. They look like a little miniature hairbrush. Each one has its own address. Each electrode can be told what to do. So it's like a little cell phone network in your brain. And with the information from a camera that's captured, we can then transform that into commands that then talk to this little cell phone network and then create vision percepts that you see in your brain. So in our case, we're bypassing the eyes, the optic nerve, and everything that comes before it. We're going right to the brain, and we're trying to see if we can actually talk to the brain and figure out how to use this amazing neural machine in order to create the perception of vision. It's surprising how even a small amount of vision perception can be extremely useful to people who have no vision perception. We think of our volunteers very much like astronauts were, because they're going to a place that's really a frontier. They're able to tell us what they can experience in ways that no one has been able to do so before. We really view them as research members of the team. We don't view them as, sometimes they're called human subjects, we don't view them that way. They're research members of the team who have the capability to tell us things that we can't know any other way. We'd be starting to recruit the 5 human volunteers that will form our little mini astronaut group that then would be the ones who would receive the devices over a 3-year period. But the volunteers will be extremely important. This will be hard work. You know, I like to say that sometimes when I give talks that there's a word for science that doesn't exist and it's science fiction. That's how it works, right? Science fiction comes from science we know. And then that fiction inspires the science to go to new frontiers, and that's where we're going. At the end of the day, it's the people we're trying to help that really matter.